Output Creation Date of a Content. Okay. Then let's create a component for that. I think I will start. Storybook for that. Oh, and let's create a new story for a date component. Here in content. No. Like this, and for now, let's make this optional and so, and let's output this here. Date and date time equals date. No, not like this. So, and let's create a new CSS module. So that can see this. So, and we need a story for this. Let's copy from headline. So, and date from date, general date. So, archetypes, we have date of type. I don't know if this is even possible. Let's see. So let's call this date demo and date demo and what a date 1, 2, 3, 4. So what's the issue here? Oh. Conversation of type, title is string, component, so type component meta, maybe mistake because there's a type. What's the problem? I don't get it. The arc times are the problem. Ah, now I got it. And let's check for now if this works. Okay. Okay, our date field is there. So as we have it there. So I think it has to look like this. Control story book controls choosing the control type. Yeah. Where are the available types of controls? Kind of. Okay. That's it. Good. Then next, let's choose a date here and check what happens. Okay. So next one would be to implement the component in Magnolia that gives the possibility to the author to show a date. For that, first thing is to create a new component, again, the wrapper component. Contact date. So. And here we have the lit date. 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 Date again. And that should be named contact date. And we will be using the date component. Maybe we will just pass this and oops, export this here. And let's also lock the props to see what we've get here. So, and after that, we need to create a new component here as well. So now, first let's create this in a CMS. Wrong place. Yep. Content date. Channel. And so, and let's create the dialogues for this. Therefore, I will check Magnolia. Come on, field definitions. Yeah. Okay. There's a date field. Label is date components. Let's keep it consistent and let's start with an uppercase C. So, and next thing would be always form. Form properties. Yeah, so that should be it. Data type of the field used a fully qualified class. Let's see what we get if we use it as this. Not available yet. So what's missing? Yeah. The reason is we need to make it available. In the areas. And before we use it, we also need to map it to the React component. That's supposed to be here. It's not a general component, it's a content component. Now I move the comma. So like this. And the component would be this. So let's see if we can use it now. Not yet. Maybe a reload fixes this. Yeah, there we have it. I can't see it. Oh, okay, there. There it is. So okay, that's the format. Let's use this in the story. Which is not open anymore. I've closed it. Apparently. So, if this is the format, so first let's remove this here. So what I need is I want to convert this. So for this, I will do local meta function human. Yeah, come on. So const human readable. No. So yeah, let's import this. And I need a formatter. Ah, first I need the locale. Apparently. Yeah, let's get this. How do we get this? From global. Do I have a global context? I think so. Not in lib, in web. Should be here? No. No. Now let's just make a search for it. There we go. Never used it. And seems not. Okay. Whoops. Let's check what's inside. So that's the app context here. There we have the locates. No, I don't need the locates, I need the locale. So, and let's also create an effect in case the language changes. Then we need to change this as well. So let's see what we get here if we do it like this. So a couple of options. Do I want the time actually? Something is not working here. I think that should be named date, but that is not the issue. The issue, okay. Good. Then let's name this Ted and Lib, correct? Yeah. So, and the Lib does not know the app context. Then let's do this. Do this like that. So, and we take this. And we will move this to the content date function. And this will be it's not necessary here. Don't we also don't need the imports here. Let's see if this works again. Yeah, not yet. For the story, we need to adjust it a bit. Go like this. Good. Okay. But oh, like this. There it is. Let's check if everything works like expected. That's weird. Why do we have new content grid item here? Yeah, okay. So let's choose a different date. And it works. Okay. Good. Now let's also style this component. How is this styled? That's switch text. No, that's not what I want. Okay, but I think let me inspect this again. Okay. So we need a translation in front of it, but this is something we do in the content date function. So actually we will need two dates, one is for creation and one is for update. So then let's rename this. Oh, come on. Oh, what's the issue here? Yeah, the reason is we named it date in Magnolia. We need to change this back. We need to change this to creation date. So, and this is required true. And a second field for update. So, and in the content date, we will maybe have the update date. Oh. Let's also rename this to make it obvious. Oh, and if we have it, we format it. If not, it will be null or empty string, so like this. So we only need to execute this code if this is available. Otherwise, we don't need to change this. So, and we will have a second one. Update date. So let's no. Use a span for this. So, and only if the update date is a present, we will use this. So, but this needs to be this. Invalid time value still. Yeah, that's true because the data set The data set doesn't have the time anymore. Yeah, to fix this, let me go into GCR and is it a main? Yes, I think it is a main. There we go. Let's delete this item. And now we should be able to go back into the, yes, now we can create it new. The issue was that we still had the date as a the attribute. So let's try this again. So this field is required. Then let's do something. Maybe we created this on 1st of January and updated this yesterday. Let's see what happens. And there we have two dates. So, but that's not how it is supposed to look like. So we need a translation for that. This is creation date. And updated at last updated. Come on, let's put the columns inside. No. But I also want to translate this into German. What's this in German? Angelegt? No. Then let's get this translation. I forgot how to. This is how to. Okay. So, and I need the translations function. So maybe we do it like this. And let's have a span here. No, not like this. Rather this. Translate. Translation context and what else? Language title. That's created at, and that's the translations context. Let's see what we get if we do this. Creation date. Okay. So, and we want the base here. That's been removed. Okay. Good. But we want a space here. So same for updated that. But I think it would be nicer if this looks like this. Let's move this. Above the headline, above this, okay. There we have an issue. The key is not correct. So now, there we go. So one last thing, I want it to be aligned right, mobile, and on smaller screens and on desktop. This working? No, not yet. Ah. So that's the wrong place for this. I need to do this here. So, but therefore I need content date dot module yep So, and we need to import this. That's one thing is not as expected. It should actually. The content grid has no padding on the right. Yeah, that's a little bit should be right. But not in that case. As from here, it is okay, but in mobile, it is pretty narrow to the right side and also to the left side. Yeah, a few pixels. It's necessary. One thing I want to find out is I think we should do this when all components are ready, so that we just do it once and that it is consistent. I think that's enough for now. So then let's stop the session for now.